So we are one day out from the election, and I'll tell you what, I don't want to be all Mr. Doom and Gloom around here. I think that'd be absolutely ridiculous, and we all know that the violence is going to get a little bit out of hand, and I just want to do something kind of fucking goofy right now. We got three polls here that have accurately predicted every election for a significant amount of time. The one that I have up here, you probably heard about before. It's the famous cookie poll that happens, and it's accurately predicted the presidential outcomes since 84. So that was Reagan's massive sweep against Mondale, and then this has been whatever accurate for every election since. And I just think that it's fun to go over these little goofy polls, because what do they actually know, right? Some of them seem to be accurate, and instead of looking at the early voting right now, which is I don't know enough about, I don't really care to, because most of the people that I do listen to when it comes to reading the results of the early voting kind of say don't look into the early voting, because it's never really a good indicator. Because you guys might remember this when I did the 2012 to 2020 comparison video. Yeah, it said early voting. Yeah, you had Romney up 49 to 48 over Obama in 2012. So yeah, exactly. Doesn't exactly properly predict anything, but apparently cookies do. And let's dive into this, which you can see here. They already kind of spurled everything. Looks like Trump's going to beat Biden according to cookies. There are a myriad of ways to predict an outcome of a presidential election, but perhaps none as telling as Buskin Bakery's presidential cookie poll, which has accurately predicted the winning president since 1984. The Cincinnati, oh good, in Ohio. I predict that's going to go strongly for Trump, but that's for another video, of course. So their poll kicked off on September 12th, and one orange-complexioned candidate is taking the lead. Trump at nearly 4,500 cookies to Biden's 3,400 cookies. 3,400 cookies. You know how bizarre it is to keep saying cookies and Biden and Trump? The only thing that's kind of similar to a cookie is hips on old frail Uncle Joe. What we got here is another one that you might know about. It's the Halloween mask poll. It's been accurate for the same amount of time since 1984. It's correctly predicted who's going to be victorious in the presidential election. And right now, it's a 66% of the sales of the masks. Political masks between the two, Biden and Trump. 66 are Trump and 34% are Biden, which is showing me that if this formula stands, that Trump will win this election. Now, honestly, this shit is patently retarded, and what does it actually mean? I don't know. Pretty much every election since 1984 has been fairly formulaic. Did you guys really think Dukakis was going to beat H.W. Bush coming off the back of a Reagan in 88? The only one that was maybe a toss-up in the air was the last incumbent defeat by, well, H.W. losing to Bill Clinton. But that one was a weird mix of H.W. being a complete and total provable liar, unlike what most people like to say about President Trump. Remember, this the only thing that you can remember from an HW presidency: read my lips, no new taxes. Immediately raises taxes, and that kills any chance that a Republican would ever have at holding their position. And add in Buck Wild Ross Perot, and yeah, that was a whole mess of a situation there in 92, and then, yeah, 8 years of Clinton, 8 years of Bush, 8 years of Obama. It was all kind of formulaic up until last year. And the same Halloween mask poll was correct, because Trump masks sold at 55% to Hillary Clinton's 45%. So I don't know, fucking take it however you want. But here's a little bit more of a concrete answer. Somebody who does non-conventional polls, who has correctly predicted presidential outcome since that magic year of 1984, Alan Lichtman. Now, he's a professor of history at American University, and his polls are based on a 13 keys strategy. Not Hunter Biden 13 keys, but like keys for a lock. And according to him, Biden is going to win. I know these aren't all pro-Trump polls. I know you're probably just as shocked as I am, but come on. I want to be fair over here. So let's go down what he thinks here. Lichtman bases his predictions on 13 keys that he has developed in collaboration with Vladimir Keyless Borok, a Russian expert on earthquakes. What a fucking weird pair of people. Their 13 keys have accurately predicted every U.S. presidential race since 1984. To develop the keys, Lichtman and Keyless Borok analyzed presidential elections over the past 120 years, and they base their prediction model on earthquake models. If just six of the 13 keys turned against the incumbent, they are in for a loss right now, Lichtman says. Trump's seven keys turned against him. All right, we'll go through that and see if there are any holes in his logic here. We asked Lichtman to describe how the keys are turning right now and how the pandemic, the fight for racial justice, no, racial supremacy, let's be completely honest, the economy does not loop back around to the pandemic, and other issues affect our presidential election. So there are seven keys turned against Trump. One, more than is needed to predict his defeat, according to the keys to the White House system that has correctly predicted the outcomes of the presidential election since 1984. His negative keys are, strap in for this, folks, because that's a little bit fucking weird. Key number one, the mandate key. Because the Republican losses in the midterm elections in 2018. Well, they gained a Senate House, and they lost significantly less than what they anticipated to and what all the models suggested in the House. But okay, yeah, you can probably give that to them, but everything is looking strong this time around, so I don't know about that. But okay, fair enough. For sake of fairness, sure, they lost some House seats, but they did gain Senate seats, by the way. Short-term economic key, because the election year recession. Well, how about governors that are purposely locking down blue states? Whitmer, Phil Scott, the guy in North Carolina, Andrew Cuomo, Gavin Newsom. Meanwhile, red states are doing extremely well, and people in blue states are flocking to those red states, which I'm not a big fan of if they don't vote the right way, but that's neither here nor there. So, okay, maybe you could give them that one. There are enough idiots out there that would probably agree with that if you look at it in a vacuum and you don't look at it in proper context. Long-term economic key. This one, I vehemently protest because of the sharp negative growth this year. Okay, we had the lockdown, and then when everything opened back up, unemployment rate, it was supposed to be, what, about 10 or 12% if you were looking at it from a positive perspective at the beginning of September. Yeah, it ended up being at about 8.5, and now it's right around 7%. I don't know, guys. And a record GDP increase at, what did I see, 33%? Yeah, here we go. This is up here at Trading Economics for the third quarter. Yeah, it went up 33%, GDP did. After it took a dive at the end of quarter one and then took a significant dive at the end of quarter two because, well, everything was locked down, right? Yeah, and then at the end of quarter three here, we got a 7.9% unemployment rate. So I don't know about that, guys. And it keeps declining sharply. I mean, that's just the most recent stat we have. So I don't know. I got to press X to doubt on that one. Social unrest because of what's raging across the land. Once again, you could tie that into the short-term economic key. Do you want to blame Trump for that? Or do you want to blame that on these blue governors that aren't doing anything about slowing it down? Maybe it is just a conspiracy. Maybe I should just grab my tinfoil hat for this one. These governors are aware of these keys and are keeping things locked down and not doing anything about the violence at the expense of their own jobs in order to fuck over Trump because TDS is so strong. I judge for yourself, but that's kind of what I'm thinking. And educated people among us kind of see that that is more or less the case. Scandal. This one doesn't make a fucking lick of sense. Trump is only the third American president to be impeached by the full U.S. House of Representatives. His approval rate went up after the impeachment failed. Yeah, we're going back to Gallup for this one. Trump job approval at a personal 49%. Yeah, February 4th. Just after the impeachment. I cannot agree with that one at all. There is no way that you can possibly spin that. And here's another one that just makes absolutely zero sense whatsoever. Foreign military success because of a lack of an acclaimed success abroad. May I remind you, there are four peace treaties in the Middle East right now, and there will be more after this. Okay, at least there's four on the books right now. If he wants to add the disclaimer this time around saying that there's not a claimed success across the board, that's another one of those things that mainstream media doesn't want to properly highlight, but it is there. And that's not normally a disclaimer that he's put on previous prognostications. So it seems a little bit off this time around. And incumbent charisma, because Trump appeals only to a narrow base. Yeah, 63 million people voted for Donald Trump. And okay, there's no evidence for this, but I'll give you some anecdotal evidence. How many times have you heard people sat out 2016 and now they're voting in the election this time around? How many Democrats have you heard that have walked away that are going to be voting for Trump now? You think he has less appeal than he did in 2016? You'd be about the only person on earth to believe that. Now, listen, the people who were turned off by Trump in 2016 that are still turned off by him in 2020, you aren't going to change those people. They might still throw away their vote on Joe Jorgensen, who is the least libertarian candidate the Libertarian Party's ever fielded. Or maybe they're feeling Yeezy and want to vote for Kanye West and whatever the fuck he's going to do. He has a destiny of leading the free world. But yeah, man, incumbent charisma because Trump appeals only to a narrow base. 63 million people in 2016. That is going to be significantly higher because right now this is the only time that I will reference early voting. 95 million people right now have voted. So that means turnout is going to be probably up, I would say, overall. And the enthusiastic people who are going to be voting tomorrow are definitely going to be Trump supporters because you can't rely on these people who run exclusively on hate to show up. You know, there's those real fucking whack jobs out there. You probably come across them if you've been on any social media platform, who are just so driven by rage that they will vote regardless against Trump. But enthusiastic Biden voters, maybe outside of Biden and Harris's family, I don't really know. I think that they'll probably get turned off by the long lines, which, come on, guys, they're just long because stupid COVID restrictions and you have to stay 6 feet apart from one another and the lines aren't going to be any longer than normal. Perhaps it will be shorter because, well, 95 million people have already cast their ballots, and that doesn't include the mail-in ballots that just showed up today as well. But yeah, I don't necessarily agree with a lot of the keys that Alan Lichtman has here, but he has been right since 1984. But yet again, so have cookies and Halloween masks. So I don't know. I guess we'll see tomorrow night. Probably. I really think we're going to know tomorrow night. But it's going to get fucking buck wild. And I just wanted to do a little fluff piece here because sometimes shit gets really, really serious around here. And I just want to keep it light because what's lighter than cookies and masks and creepy old Jews with one of their pet poodles stapled to their head? Like, honestly, if that's not a hair club for men, a Ringo Starr cast-off wig, man, that dude has some terrific genetics. But that looks as thick as a Berber rug, in my opinion. Anyways, guys, thank you all very much for the gift of your time. I've been Don Consuelo. I want you guys to follow your gut and get after it. Take care, everyone.